number.
Yep, which is available from the 19th to the 30th, 0800 100 900, there it is now, and you can call that number. I want to know, though, what it is, because you used to drink, smoke, major diets, and all of a sudden, 38, new reformed woman. New reformed woman.
No, not that reformed.
Stop smoking. Stop smoking. Get cut down on drinking.
I don't smoke.
Vegetarian.
I'm a bit of a binger, really. I try not to drink, but every now and then I just think, oh, sod it. Got to get pissed.
How about the smoking, though? Do you mind?
You partake in a little bit of alcohol. You get inebriated. I think that's what. If you went to school, you'd have known it was inebriated.
I drink the brewery dry and the grapes grow again. I like chocolate. I like eating. I think the one thing that I've determinedly given up is dieting, because I used to starve myself through my 20s. I'm very short, I'm naturally pudgy, and I've just got to live with that. I'm not going to starve myself
anymore.
But
they don't work, diets, because if diets worked, there'd just be one, and we'd all do it. So everybody tries everything. But there's more pressure on women to diet than there is on
men.
The
funny thing that you should say that today. What day is it today? If anybody knows, it's International No Diet Day.
Yay!
Much cheer from the women. Yeah.
Check anything.
I'm going out to buy a box of chocolates now.
if you're a binger, do you think that comes from, you know, you're working a lot, aren't you?
Never get to eat.
But you know, if you're very, very busy like that, then you treat yourself and go for the sort of big one. Do you find, is it that? Are you a workaholic?
No, I'm an insomniac, so I eat through the night.
I eat through the night. I wake up regularly. I wake up four times a night, and I've got to have a chocolate biscuit and a drink to go back to sleep.
But you're a skinny beast.
Sorry. It's disgusting.
I'm just waiting for the day she walks in and she's this big.
It'll happen. But what do you eat in the middle of the night? Do you crave? What happens?
It's chocolate. If I know there's chocolate in the house, and I get my husband to hide it, and if I can't find it, I go through every room.
It becomes like a game then, doesn't it?
I wake him up.
I've hidden the chocolate.
Yeah.
Where?
But I know where
it's
hidden.
Like, you wake up. I couldn't go to sleep knowing there was a game with a prize at the end of it. I don't know where the chocolate is tonight. Have you hidden chocolate? Yeah, I've hidden chocolate. Where?
Do you know what I try and do is hide the chocolate. I think I'll hide it from myself.
Well, don't buy it.
No, can't do that. Because I know I'm going to crave. But I think I'll hide it from myself. I won't find it. I always find it. It's amazing.
Well, the shop's full of it out there. You don't have to look that far.
I mean, you mentioned your husband. How long have you been married?
I've been married now. I'm in my 11th year.
Mm. You were a bit wary of him when you first met him, weren't you?
I thought he was weird when I first met him. He's like a little English professor. He's got little round glasses, and he's very, very polite. It's like, hello, how do you do? And I went to work with him. I went to make an album with him, and my manager said, be careful, the quiet ones are the ones that you have to look out for. And I was just terrified of this guy. I thought he was going to pounce on me. He did propose within a week.
Really?
Yeah. He apparently, he said to all his friends, because he lived in New York at the time, and he said, I'm going to England, I'm going to meet my wife. And they said to him, what do you mean? And he said, well, I'm working with this singer called Toya Wilcox, and I know I'm going to marry her. And he's just, he's so sweet, you know, he's like too good to be true sometimes. And
did he bring about a lot of changes in you then, do you think?
He made me worse in a way, really, because he is quiet and he's sedate and he knows what he wants from life. And I'm completely the opposite. So there was quite a few years of rebellion, really. But he's the best person on the planet. I just adore him.
Should point out, of course, he is Robert Fripp, and he was 11 years with King Crimson. I mean, the man does have a history.
Oh, he's just a brilliant man. And when I met him, I had severe temper, and I was drinking an awful lot. And he managed to kind of help me get out of that by just talking me through the emotions I go through, because in Birmingham I was a terrible fighter. I'd get in scraps on the bus and people just despaired of me, and he's helped me deal with this temper, which is all frustration, because
he's a very calming influence, isn't he?
He's brilliant. He can articulate. Mm. And I think part of aggressive people's problems is they can't articulate, and that was my problem.
Well, hopefully through Adult Learning Week, people will start taking it seriously, and they'll call the free phone number. Ladies and gentlemen, Toya Wilcox. And we'll remind you of that free phone number again, because the week runs all the way through from the 19th to 30th of May. It's 0800 100 900. Now, after the news, your chance to win £1,000. We'll